I like proving niggas wrong. I do what they say I can't. They call me Cardi, Cardi, banging body, spicy mommy, hot tamale, hotter than a Somali. Virgo, Ferrari, hop up the stoop, jump in the coupe. Big dip on top of the roof, flexing on bitches as hard as I can. Eating halal, driving a Lamb. Saw that bitch, I'm sorry though. Got my coins like Mario. Yeah, they call me Cardi B. I run this shit like cardio. Diamond district in the chain. Certified, you know I'm gang, 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 gang.
Legends never die. When the world is calling you, can you hear them screaming out your name? Legends never die. They become a part of you. Every time you play by reaching greatness, relentless, you survive.
All right. So we got Vortex and Rabid Raccoons. Vortex bans out Morgana first. Obviously trying to take, hopefully that's Ucklar. Uckler? I'm not sure how to pronounce his name, but we're going to go with Uckler. Banning Morgana against him. High priority pick right now. Alistair. Going against the supports. Maybe they're trying to block out the funnel strat. Man Walrus likes to play heavy engage. End of the line. Blue side and banning Graves. That doesn't seem 100%. Maybe Luker just doesn't want to play that champion. Putting heavy bans on Man Walrus, trying to put him on a lower tier support.
Go.
And the brand. It's a heavy bot lane centric draft. Or ban phase.
Think carefully.
Obviously, Rabid Raccoons does not want to have Man Walrus on a good support champ. Homekinch early pick. Trying to look for an immobile AD carry, most likely. Something. Oh, what the? I lied. So far, Aatrox Kindred works really well together. They do lock in that Swain. It's a very good start of the draft. They all have a really good synergy with each other, and it gives Kindred really free ganks on either lane. Then you got Tahmkench and Heimerdinger. See what they're going to lock in. Probably should grab the jungle here. That or a high priority ADC. Ooh, Talia. Is that a Talia mid or a Talia jungle is the question, because her jungle clear got hurt quite a bit with that extra 2 seconds on her Q early levels. Rabid Raccoons needs to wait. Why did? I guess they're pretty sure Swain's gonna be going ADC. Ban for mid as well, or bot. They might be a little weary of where the Swain's gonna go.
Pathetic.
Talent ban. It's a safe ban. Yeah, he is MIA right now, Aizen. Star AD carry. Lucian. So, still, Lucian could go to mid. Is it a swim bot? Lucian could still go mid lane right now. Could be a Lucian mid, Heimerdinger, or Tahmkench bot with Talia jungle. Yeah, Swain ADC, Ryze mid, or could be Ryze bot as well. Ryze or Swain bot with Rakan would be really good. I don't honestly know what their champ pools are. And then Lucian can. I'm still not sure where everyone's going on their team. Alright, Bard. Tahmkench top into the Aatrox. I did not expect that come out. And Talia jungle, Heimerdinger, Bard, huh. The Lucian mid. Yeah. This draft is wild. I honestly don't know what to think of it. I'm pretty sure Ryze is going to lose early into Lucian, but then he has free ganks on Lucian, especially if Lucian's going Ignite. It's just free ganks. They get blow his flash, and then he has no way to get away. Every time. Should be free ganks for Kindred. And then Tahmkench and Aatrox. Tahmkench is basically a sitting duck as well. Their winning lane is bot lane. That's where Talia needs to be playing around. Yeah, this is a wild draft, though. The pressure's on the first couple early levels for Talia to help Lucian and bot, like mid and bot out, and get them ahead, put Ryze in a bad spot, and force Kindred to be down bot lane and not snowballing the Aatrox and the Ryze. Because the early levels, Heimerdinger Bard's definitely going to win versus Rakan Swain. What are y'all thinking is going to happen? Place your votes. Who do you think is going to win? Let's get some music back on while we wait.
Deep in their boats, they're riding too small when the fire is big.
All right, so going for the 5-man start, 5-point start. Setting up, just watching everything. Not really sure why Rides is watching top and Kindred's watching mid, though. That's different. Kindred's going to be starting bot side, and Talia most likely be starting bot as well. Moving up towards Raptors, taking those. Oh, never mind. Bait and switch. Lucian's running bone plating in this lane. It's really safe. Trying to keep him alive while he's I'm getting messaged a lot, sorry. He's trying to keep himself alive in the lane in case he does get ganked in camp. It's pretty safe and good strat. I can't talk, I'm sorry. Going for the mark. Really good roams. Oh, pickaxe. Oh, no. Oh, this is a good play by Lucian, Mad Life mid laner. Pickaxe not respecting it. Mic is quiet. Okay, I'll find a way to turn it up. I don't know why my directed camera is not looking over there. That's crazy. Let's rewind that real quick. So she goes in for the pick. Oh, that's a free kill. I'll turn my mic up in 1 second. Oh no, Loker. Go back. Oh god. That's depressing. Oh. Whoop. Sorry, guys. I was trying to speed up. I didn't think another fight would happen that fast. Swain with the hard engage in the recon. W. Ooh, good pick. Both waste and flash, though. It should be an easy kill for the Heimerdinger. Oh, nope. He's overextending. Could easily get caught out. Gosh, guys. I'm sorry. I am really tired. I need to wake up. I'm going to try to get my mic quality back up. Alright, I'm going to fix my mic real quick while this is... I can't cast while this is going on, I'm sorry. Can you make it? Yeah, you can see that. I'm sorry. Yeah. Sorry, guys. I was trying to make my mic louder. I don't know why it's so quiet right now. Trying to make my mic louder and then I can try to cast better. That might make it better. Hopefully it did. All right, Kendrick going for the steal on the mark and the Raptors. Got the smite off. Overextended, though. Now she's putting herself in a really... She's putting herself really far behind. We have... top lane's even. And then... Lucian getting ahead of the Ryze. Heimerdinger getting a slow CS lead, but it should be about even in gold. And Rakan got a kill. Rixalis getting slowly caught. They should be able to. They could actually fight this if. Nope. I lied. Oh, geez. Looker's still level 3. Getting hard punished right now. It should be an easy kill for Rabid Raccoons. Yeah, Vortex slowly falling down in the gold. I really am horrible at casting today, I'm sorry. And then... Mike is much better. Cool. So, Logar needs to just try to farm up. Stop worrying about his mark so much. Try to get a little back into the game with XP and focus on his bot lane. His bot lane's doing really well making picks for themselves, so he needs to try to extend on that. Oh, come on, Ryze. Alright. Bard having to flash. That should have been a free kill, but he didn't even use his Q on Ryze. We have... They're still worrying about... They're trying to worry about the dragon right now on Vortex. They just need to get vision on it and play safe. Tahm Kench is chasing down the Aatrox. Might actually be able to do some damage. Wow. Tahm Kench bullying the Aatrox right now. Rixalis has to run away. Ooh, barely gets out with his life, having to pop the ultimate, though. Beastnik showing why they allowed that through. Talia slowly getting a commanding lead on the Kindred. Oh, the accidental stopwatch play from the Bard. Yikes. It's alright, though. He's just showing him what's up. He doesn't need that to beat them, is what he's saying. Obviously. Come on. This would be Peacock without some BM. Nice stun coming out. Kindred needs to not worry about this mark so much. Even well, Lucian's back, so she actually could. It might be down already, though. Oh, should be a free pick. She does have flash, though. Kindred queuing into the E. Oh, God. Nice pickup from Pickaxe, though, but still giving the kill over to Talia. Ooh. Rakan going in with the ultimate. Swain, free. Good pick up the free kill on the Heimerdinger. They're overextending quite a bit down bot. Definitely need to be calling for Talia or... Even both bot lanes need to be calling for their jungler, putting pressure, getting the dragon off these kills. This should be free dragons after it. Oh, Tahm Kench going into the minion wave, showing the Aatrox how big his balls are. Oh. And looks like Vortex might be going in for the free Infernal Drake, knowing that Talia is going to be trying to take that mark. She's actually on a red, though. It's a nice play, knowing that their bot lane got killed and had to recall, so picking up that dragon. Ooh, Aatrox, Rixalis in a bad spot right now. He can just hop over the wall, though, with a Z. Lucian's trying to just force the kill on him. Ooh. Should be a free kill for the Lucian. Rixalis not having ultimate or any summoners up. Talia. Rabid Raccoon's taking advantage of the... the Aatrox being behind. Should be going to get this first tower and blue buff. So Kindred needs to be going bot lane with Ryze, doing a 4-man bot as soon as the Rakan and Swain get back. But Rakan's going mid. They should be four manning this down bot lane, getting the kills in the tower and trading. But they're going to trade for mid tower anyways. Will they be able to get it though? The nameplates? Yeah, the nameplates are flipped, I know. I did it before they were on sides, that's my fault. Hang on. I'll fix the nameplates real quick. I didn't think I was actually going to be able to cast this. I was just going to host it, but then the caster had to sub in. So I got emergency voted into cast. Kendra's on the bot side. She hasn't backed yet, though. I don't believe she backed off that. I wasn't. No, she's backing now. Tahm Kench using the ultimate. Ooh, they're stunning up the Swain. Very good ultimate from Rakan. Late Bard ultimate, though. Should be a free double kill. Swain already got the first one. Ooh, had to blow stopwatch. Multiple flashes burnt. Very nice prediction on the Swain snare. Did I miss Bull Raccoons? I did miss Bull Raccoons. Yikes. I spelled Raccoons, sorry. Yikes. Alright, very nice from Vortex. Trying to equalize the gold lead. Still at a 700 gold disadvantage. Oh, Lucian overextending, getting very cocky. Ooh, Roxalis with a nice flash Q into the W. What? Rise ultimate, just to get away. I'm not gonna lie, I don't know all the names of the ultimate or of the ability, so forgive me. Alright. Vortex going top, obviously seeing Talia and Bard on the ward they're clearing. Should be a free pickup on this Herald. They could easily do this pretty quick. Their team fight is much better. Items. Yes, I don't have them up at all times. Sorry. Honestly, Rabid Raccoons just need to give this. They can't team fight this. They just need to be shoving the waves out, not letting the bot the top wave be shoved as hard as it is. Because they can just take this Rift Herald and move it top lane. And they need to be sending Talia up there to try to stop it as well. Giving bot tower. But instead, they didn't send Tilly up in time, so they could just use the Rift Herald here. Ooh, nice pickup. Nice pick from the Tilly and Tahm Kench. Might actually be able to get two from this. Oh, no. Alright, got TB coming in from Heimerdinger. Flash from Kindred. Tahm Kench looking to pick up the Rakan kill. Oh. Kindred getting another mark. Nice W coming out from the Rakan. Ooh. Lucian coming to clean up. Almost a double kill for him. His ultimate, the calling's coming up. Pickaxe gonna step up and take the damage. Ooh. Definitely gonna be a double kill coming up. Oh, very nice escape. TP coming from the Swain. This game is non-stop action, and I'm not an amazing play-by-play. The Rift Herald's having a seizure over here in the corner, not really understanding where he needs to be. She needs to be. Shelly, where are you at? Why are you doing this? You're having a meltdown. I'm sorry. They let her out of her cage. She didn't know where to go. Rift Herald chose not to hit the tower. Its one job was not executed correctly. Kindred marking the Talia. 5-1 Lucian right now. Alright, picking up the Scuttle Crab. We got 3-man Vortex bot lane, setting up for the dragon. It is another Infernal Drake.
Oh,
They have top lane looks like it's shoving in for Vortex favor, shoving against into Rabid Raccoon's side. And bot lane looks like it's also shoving. So the waves are in a good spot for Vortex besides mid lane. But they have Swain going to match it. Loker stepping up quite a bit, showing no fear into the face of three people. Oh, now they're giving up all their pressure though. They have it five there. Might see a team fight coming out. Ooh. One thing that Rabid Raccoon side has for him is the heavy poke. Ooh. Not able to get. Rez easily able to get out of that. Nice Bard ultimate coming out. Rakan jumping in with the R. Oh my good. Aatrox just going ham by himself. Kindred and the team hiding in the ultimate. Aatrox gets pulled, knocked out of his ultimate. Somehow Vortex is cleaning up this fight. Talia having to flash away. Loker's still alive. Looking for the Heimerdinger. Talia's trying to come up and clean up a few kills. Swain can easily kill this. All he has to do is dodge the threat of volley. Oh, Loker picking up another stack and a kill. Can pick up the Heimerdinger kill if he chooses to. Gonna have to play it smart though. 1W and auto attack might take out Loker. He doesn't know he's on a ward right now though. Spam this ogre. Alright. Should be a free Infernal Drake pickup. Heimerdinger just needs to take the recall. Someone needs to go top lane on the side of Rabid Raccoons. Very nice team fight from Vortex, even though it was very sloppy at the beginning. Rakan suiciding in just to get the charm with his ultimate. Loker having to put the team on his back right there. Clean up those kills with the help of Aatrox and Ryze. Alright, so we got Rabicoons trying to get some vision out topside, set up, repair, trying to take the mid tier 2 hopefully, running around as a 3 man, but they don't, I don't think they know that there's 4 in the topside, 4 Vortex. Trying to make a pick on this Aatrox possibly, but I don't know if they know that's warded. The gold has almost equalized. There's a 600 gold lead going in for Rabid Raccoons. 500 now. Kindred still super behind in CS compared to the Talia. But she's been forcing fights a lot. And Talia's been actually doing almost equally in fights. Mid lane, Lucian has a tiny CS lead of about 27. And... tiny, I say. Yeah. I mean, Vortex is ahead in stats, and they're about equal in gold. The double Infernal gives them a huge stat increase compared to the side of Rabid Raccoons. Heimerdinger being 0-5 really hurts Rabid Raccoons, because they picked that lane to win, and they lost. They didn't put any pressure down there to help win it, even though they had the shoving lane, and they got caught a lot. The 4-1 Rakan, though, showing he has no fear. Ooh, the support CS is super equal. They're both doing very well with their 8 CS. And Heimerdinger having a CS lead over Swain is actually... very obvious, just because they were pushing Swain in, and it's really hard for Swain to CS perfectly under tower early, unless Rakan can help him. But the double or the melee into Swain having to flash Tahm Kench ultimate, getting a good nice pick on with the snare, taking him down to about half HP. He's gonna still heal up about 25% of that, so he's gonna be at 75 HP. Still chasing him in, Ryze flashing. Having a blop to E though, so Tahm Kench is going to be very low. Colin coming out. Talia ult as well. Big wall. Ooh. Trying to get a pick on the Lucian. Lucian popped very low. Talia makes a pick on the Swain. And they're going to backtrack now. Swain being a little too far out, not able to get the Kindred Ultimate on him. Nice pick from the Talia. Lucian. They're setting up the top lane now. It's Rabid Raccoons. Going. They don't have the Talia Ultimate or Lucian Calling or Tahm Kench, but. And all the ultimates are up. Oh, Ryze. Oh, Rakan going in. Ryze as well. Picking the Talia. Very nice. Got Swain three on the back line, 1v3. Aatrox coming in to help out. Swain gets picked, but they're managed to pick up one, two. And going for the three. That's three. Nice. 1 for 5 on the side of Vortex. And going to get the free Baron after that. Gold swinging heavily into the Vortex's favor after this Baron. And another Dragon's coming up in a minute and a half. At this point, Vortex is doing the right thing by forcing these team fights. Rakan is doing a very good job going in, making his team engage, and having his team back him up. If Rabid Raccoons wants to win this, they're going to have to stop trying to force team fights they don't win and just force the objectives in bad spots. They need to have wave shoving on the sides and using Tahm Kench ultimate and bringing in Lucian. Tahm Kench and Lucian need to be making picks together with the ultimate, and having Talia go as well with her R. Tahm Kench and Lucian together, Lucian being really fed, make it really easy, and Talia can just use her ride the wall as well, make picks, try to catch people out, but Vortex is doing a good job of staying together. New Dragon's coming up in 40 seconds, and it is going to be a Mountain Drake. Really would help Vortex at this point, not too much in the side of Rabid Raccoons, because they're the ones losing a lot of their time, or a lot of the team fights, so if Vortex gets this, they can push down faster, and unless Rabid Raccoons can find a way to use their picks correctly, it's going to be a bad time. Should be able to get this mid tower, though, just from the Baron up cannon minion, moving into the dragon. But Rabid Raccoons has a lot of pink wards and wards set up, getting the vision, already got the Scuttle Crab. They definitely just need to give this dragon and force Vortex into a bad spot. They cannot teamfight them. Talia is going for the mark, though, for some reason, leaving her team 4 man in the mid lane. Having to escape, didn't get the tower out of that. Did get the Ryze ultimate out of the way. But now they don't have Talia ultimate to stop this push or slow down the push, and they're all in a very bad spot. They should lose this mid tower because of this. Rabbitkin's trying to make something happen. Going for the almost good play mid lane to get that tower, but did not follow through with it very well. Talia should have been there in the beginning, and they could have walled off to get that tower and then escaped. Vortex looking for a pick in the jungle right now, trying to catch them slipping as they go top lane to block this tower from falling. Items. Yeah, I'm going to be bad about that, okay? I'm sorry. I put it down when stuff's happening, and then I'll have to put it back. Yell at me. Ooh, Talia getting caught out. Having a flash. Nice pick from the Kindred. Rakan forcing the flash of this W. Oh my goodness. Ryze and Swain blowing up the Bard. At this point, Vortex is just taking this game over and forcing their victory down the enemy team's throat. They drafted a very hard, they needed to win early team comp and use their advantages, and they just didn't use any of them to their advantage, so Vortex is going to take the win team fights every single time. Very good Rakan ultimate coming out. Swain going in, blowing up the back line. This game looks right about over. Talia and Bard coming up, trying to stop But they should just take this inhib and recall. Don't get too greedy. Talia ult coming out, trying to make a pick, stop these backs. Ooh. Rakan going in, very nice. Kindred ult to save him. Everyone on the team somehow getting an assist on that. Vortex having a shaky first couple minutes of the game. But once the team fight started coming around in the mid, they just rolled over this. They don't need their AD carry to win games, is what they're trying to tell us. Yeah, Talia making a desert play. High reward. Super high risk. If it worked out. And that was a big ol' if. I mean, she would have got a lot of gold out of it, so it would have been a high reward. Because even the kill on the Rakan would have been a shutdown gold. Would have picked up a decent chunk of change. But she couldn't manage to pick anything up. If Rabid Raccoons managed to get a kill on anybody, especially Ryze, it's going to be a huge gold chunk coming in their favor. But right now they have Tahmkench and Talia top lane as they're losing their bot tier too. Nice fat minion wave coming down though. Making this should be another free tower. They might even lose the inhib off this push. They have no way to defend the hammer turrets. Ooh, pickaxe going in deep, showing he has no fear against, and he gets picked by the Talia. Bold move. Swain dies as well. Kindred are still up. Oh, Tom ulting in by himself solo. No one with him. Slowly putting this back. Oh, Lucian coming in hot. Culling should be coming out soon. Rakan ultimate going in. Heimerdinger having to flash away. Kindred kills the Lucian. Rakan having to flash away. Talia's running from the Aatrox. Manwalers and Rexalis trying to stop their backs. Talia's out of mana though. Should be free kill up for the Aatrox, blowing him up. Heimerdinger's overextended now. I still don't know if they can kill them. Ooh, nice ignite though coming out. And Aatrox might still get the kill. Ooh, he does. Wow. Oh, nope, Ryze came in from the back. Jeez. It's four man down on the side of Rabid Raccoons. Just Tahmkench to hold the towers. I still think this might be an overstay. They do have a nice fat minion wave going out. Oh. Never mind, Vortex showing me that it's not going to be an overstay. They're just going to make this game end very quickly. Vortex coming out with the clean win towards the end of the game. Very shaky start, but Red Raccoons put themselves in a huge disadvantage by going in early game with an early draft and not playing towards it at all. They got a lot of good picks on the Kindred, put her down a lot, and I think Talia was level 5 to Kindred's 3 at one point, and then Kindred popped back up, and they abused that. They abused their team fights really well. Well played a Manwalrus on that Rakan. They banned out a lot of his supports and still left a Rakan open. Not sure if that was the wisest choice. He played a mean Rakan that game. Let's look at the damage charts. So, Ryze coming up with the most damage on Vortex, and Talia, most damage in the game. She played pretty well in team fights. Just wasn't enough. The Heimerdinger was so far behind, couldn't do anything in team fights. Lucian tried as well. The bot lane was just really, really far behind in a huge... just... I don't even know the word right now. They were... it was really bad for Red Raccoons to have their bot lane losing as hard as they did on a winning lane early. Alright, well, we're about to get ready for the next game. Gotta find the code to get in. Do y'all think this is gonna be a 2-0 by Vortex, or do you think the Rabid Raccoons can tie it up, make it 1-1? After that showing, I think Rabid Raccoons could do it. The problem is they're gonna have to put their best foot forward and not draft a team comp that's team fight is so atrocious. The Tahm Kench was a really nice pick into the Aatrox. He bullied him very hard. But he's gonna have to. They're gonna have to drop the bot lane that just isn't gonna lose. Their bot lane is just gonna have to play smarter and have their jungler call their jungler down a lot, because that should have been a lane where the Swain and Rakan were pretty far down, but it just wasn't correctly used as a team, and their bot lane overextended too much, getting caught out and pulled into tower range quite a few times by the Swain. Their macro wasn't too bad, in my opinion, on Rabid Raccoons. I think Vortex just had a really better draft. That if they weren't behind at 20 minutes, they just were auto going to win, in my opinion. Which is fine. But, oh my goodness. But... if you're going to draft that way on the side of Rabid Raccoons, you have to... jeez, my eardrums. I'm sorry, stream. They're just going to have to draft a better bot lane fight, team fight, because the Bard and the Heimerdinger together just isn't going to do very much when you have a Lucian mid and a Tahlia jungle. You need to engage somewhere if you're planning on fighting a team fighting comp, or disengage, but they had neither. The Bard isn't going to be able to disengage very well. And really no one else is on their team. If they had a really strong tank top, it would have been nice, like Ornn or Mundo, but they had no engage and no disengage, so it was very difficult. Yeah. Picking a favorable mid bot is fine. The problem is they didn't do it correctly. They didn't call the jungler down for Rabid Raccoons and got picked a lot, so that really hurt their team. Lucian was doing really well, and so was Tahm Kench. Tahm Kench wasn't losing lane either. They picked the two of their lanes won. The problem is bot lost so hard, and the Kindred was really far down, but they didn't abuse it enough and actually do anything with it. Aatrox was really far behind, and Lucian killed him multiple times, but they allowed Vortex to make picks with their team comp and force team fights instead of making picks of their own with the Tahm Kench and Lucian and forcing 4v5s. Yeah, Heimerdinger is definitely one of the best bot lane mages. Sorry, I'm not on spectate, guys. My bad. the Bard and, like, their draft really wasn't completely awful. The biggest problem was not allocating their resources to the right place, like calling their jungle and using the jungle in mid ahead. And Tahm Kench, they could have 5-man bot lane. Had Tahm Kench ult the Lucian in bot, after they killed Aatrox, they could have backed one time, had Lucian come bot with Tahm Kench R, and Tahlia ult in from behind, take that tower and move the dragon. Even while they had Kindred really far behind. But they were forcing 2v2s and skirmishes that they didn't need to be taking until team fights came along. But Vortex played it really well by stalling and doing skirmishes and then team fights. Their early game was really rough because Aatrox got really far behind. Kindred got really far behind. And Ryze wasn't doing too hot as well. So they had three people not doing too well on the side of Vortex early game, but they managed to stall it out and play a very nice mid to late game. Vortex might be getting their AD back. I'm going to switch the stuff real fast on here. I might have a co-caster coming in. Sorry for my atrocious color casting last game. Honestly, I think Mundo and Tom Kench, I don't know if it was just the players or the champions. I'm not too sure 100% on that, but I know Mundo does well. Hey, what is up?
Fellow casting partner, your mic is muted on Discord.
Oh, hey, what is up? My bad.
Hey, that's good.
My color casting, or my play-by-play is atrocious, so trying to do that last game, not fun.
Oh, yeah, that was a fucking, freaking fighting game. That game
It was very hard because I'd be like trying to start explaining
they're
something.
Hitting each other.
And then I was like,
still hitting each other.
It was like, wait, I was like, the team fight's over. I don't know what's going on. Oh my goodness. Okay. And yeah, we're back. Yeah. And and I don't remember the names of any ultimates right now or any abilities. Then I was like, I don't know what's going on. And they're going in. And we're on ultimate. And I'm just lost. And I don't know what's going on. And I'm sorry, guys. Poor stream.
Fair enough, dude.
But, and then I just decided to try to focus on, color casting as much as I could, and then I was like, this is not going to work because I still have to play-by-play every 10 seconds.
Right, you got to cut yourself off.
I'm like, and I'm cutting myself off, let's go.
Got to cast.
I felt like I was on Anchorman, just like.
That game was scrappy.
It was fun. Horrible, but it was great. Y'all played a really great mid to late game, and your Rakan played amazing, in my opinion. MVP of that match, in my opinion.
Yeah, he played pretty well. He did a good job. Good bot lane play. I didn't really see what happened too much bot lane.
It wasn't even just bot lane. Team fights, he started a lot of team fights off. Very good decision making in every single one, almost. But.
Can't even spell.
That's okay. I misspelled raccoons in the stream for a second. Hey, let me know if you hear my co-caster decently, because I'll try to turn him up if not.
Yeah, it's actually such a good thing to point out, because there's times where it's so hard to hear the other caster. Not just on P-Cup, but like in general.
Yeah.
It's really yikes.
Has like a 9-second delay or something like that, or 15. He's good. Okay, you're good. I had to turn myself up because I was quiet. Alright, so I'm not going to lie, I don't know very many people in this game. I know Loker, Manwalrus, and Rexalis. That's about it. So, when y'all are doing draft last game, I had no idea where any of the champions were 100% going.
Actually really funny because this team, Raccoons, played against my team in the play-ins, and we did the best of three. I think you saw that. Mm-hmm. The best three tie to get into peak up.
Yeah, I saw that.
I was still part of Square One. It's on vacation right now. We're going to pick things up closer to the play-in season. I just don't feel like it's worth really putting much effort in right now.
What do you play right now?
I mostly just like work right now. I haven't been able to play too much League.
Oh, okay.
So it was really good that I didn't end last game.
Yeah, we my team had a bit of a oopsies the other night, and my mid laner and support decided they didn't want to play anymore. Had nothing to do with like internal issues. It was they just aren't having fun with the game. So
maybe I'll join.
Gotta play though.
I'm in. How often do you practice?
Like 3 times a week.
What's like the time?
Oh, it depends on like everyone's schedule. We're talking about P Cup. Are we talking about joining teams right now?
You're poaching me. You're poaching me right now on cast. Crap. Yeah, yeah.
Can't do that. See, you asked though. I can't poach. I gotta talk to your. I might have to talk to your team captain and see if rules are allowed. I don't know how poaching goes in this. You're gonna have to get permission like Meteos did before he got benched and thrown off. Oh, going into champ select.
Yeah, yeah. Yikes. All right, going into champ select here. Longest champ select ever. Curious to see how this pick ban goes now that they have their actual AD.
Alistair ban.
Yeah, we'll see if they get 5 support bans.
They did try to target Manwaters last game, and they did not take out the Rakan for some reason.
Actually, he doesn't really play too much Rakan, but since they're blue side here, I wouldn't be surprised if they first pick Rakan, because Uckler is actually like a nasty Rakan. So that would be my assumption of how Raccoon should play the draft here.
They could go Desire. I don't know if they funnel, but they could do Desire Rakan if Uckler is a good Rakan player, as you say.
They definitely have enough team synergy to do funnel. So they could, but I'm not sure if it's likely. We'll see. I'm willing to like bet money they first pick Rakan.
Let's see. The brand ban again. I don't know who plays it on Rabid Raccoons, but they're not wanting that brand to come out.
Yeah. What's up? Big reason why we banned it in the game we played is because we knew we were going to do Swain Bot, and this is not fun to lane against.
Kindred ban.
Yeah, they definitely didn't play smart around the marks last game.
I don't think either team actually did.
Well, we discussed like pushing waves and stuff, but it was just like we had a scaling lane mid against Lucian. Like, that's very unfun. So we lost a lot of pressure there, but he did secure a lot of marks.
Ooh, here you go. You were correct.
Call that. Knew that was coming.
So, in this situation, they already took the Rakan. What do you think Vortox is going to respond with?
I think Vortox is going to get the Zaya, potentially.
They could take the Zaya away. If they take the Zaya away, then what do they pair with it? Ooh, Camille.
Nope. Yeah, no, they have to take Aatrox here. Thesis is too strong of a champ.
Yeah, I'm surprised he got let through.
Yeah. All right, we'll see if they take the Zaya here. If they don't, maybe they take... I just don't see them picking anything other than Zaya. I feel like it might be a mistake if they don't.
They don't take Zaya. Zoe's still open. The Taric pick. I don't know if that's Zaya. There we go.
Yeah, there's a Zaya. Zoe's still open, though. If they take that, they're actually, I think.
They could easily take the Zoe right here into Mundo, and that'd be a very good start for Rabid Raccoons. And they have the engage, they have the tank, and they have a strong mid mage who doesn't have very many counters.
Yep. That's true. I don't really know if Madlight plays that, and he also doesn't seem to like blind picking his mid. So,
ooh, the Kai'Sa. It's possible. That's a really early
Kai'Sa. That's a good flex. It's a good flex.
It could be funnel, or it could be ADC.
All right, we'll see what they pick here. There's a lot of options.
I do think they need to draft this Mundo early, though, because they ban, like, Mundo's a decent matchup for top lane and beat the Aatrox early.
Yeah. They may go for the Tom again. It didn't do too bad. We'll see.
Tom Kitch again, yeah.
So I assumed he was definitely wasn't enjoying that lane, definitely, last game. No,
I could tell. Rexalis definitely was not. The Taric pick. So far, the draft in favor, in my opinion, is going over to Vortex. Banning the Yasuo, though.
Yeah, definitely don't want that through. They may ban a Talon here.
Most likely.
Or Zed.
I think the Talon is more of a respectable ban than the Zed, because Zaya can just R as soon as Zed ults in, blocks a lot of his damage.
It's true. It is a pretty big comfort pick for Madlife, I believe, but Talon just can be played by pretty much anybody.
Nocturne coming out. Oof.
Yeah. Talia, maybe, in my opinion, kind of showing that the Kai'Sa may be a funnel, because if you're going to go with a funnel, you want to get rid of champs like Nocturne. So I think it's highly likely that Kai'Sa is a funnel. and they may go for a supporting mid.
If they're getting rid of it, though, then they definitely need to ban another high-priority jungler. The Zoe ban, though. I'm actually shocked they banned that away.
Yeah, that further solidifies the funnel, I think.
I mean, yeah. They do. Right now, the funnel looks like the best option for them because Tahm, Kench, and Rakan together, very good for that.
I think Aesol would be really good for blue, red side here to kind of perma shove in that funnel.
It would be good if they're predicting that. Oh, placeholder coming out.
Placeholder, yeah. The big G man. Is anyone but Aizen owned a lot of champs. But. Oh, yeah, I get to say his name properly for people. It is definitely Aizen.
It is Aizen. Trundle is up. Does anyone know what the pick is for that? Because I did not get messaged.
I will ask. if I can find any of them on my friends list. Okay. What is that pick? Oh, okay. Maybe it isn't a funnel. Wow.
I don't know if I like this decision to not funnel, actually, because so far their team comp would be really nice into it. And the Trundle taken away.
Ooh. Wait, Trundle's on red side, though. That's what David just told me. Loker just told me.
Do they know that Trundle's over there, though?
Hopefully not a miscommunication. I'm sure he's spamming him right now. Ooh, okay, yeah. The Evelynn.
Oh, Sejuani pick.
Sejuani.
That's a really decent draft. Besides, my biggest problem is that they actually don't have a lot of wave clear. So if they get behind, they're just going to lose the lane, lose the game again. They did not draft. Their draft is all about picks. And because their team fight's not even going to win on the side of Rabbit Raccoon, the blue side. Aatrox, Xayah. Yeah, I think Vortex has a way better team fight. So what they're going to want to do is look for picks on the side of Rabbit Raccoons, but they're basically doing a draft just like last game where they're going to have to put high priority in certain lanes and force their win condition early. And if they don't, then by 25 minutes, the game's over.
Tahm, Kench can eat Lissandra's ult to target, right?
Yes.
Okay. So yeah, I don't really agree with the Lissandra pick there.
The Lissandra pick, in my opinion, is just basically because it was TF mid, and Lissandra's very good into the TF.
I guess so, yeah. He's pretty immobile, and she can match him in a lot of ways if he goes TP as well.
Yeah, and also Lissandra, if TF ever tries to push and then roam, Lissandra can always push as well and then just TP. So, or she can just follow up using her E to get over the wall and come down.
Mm-hmm.
But it's going to be up to her to keep an eye on Twisted Fate because they do need... Rabdokins does need to get ahead early. So he should be spamming his ult on 6, and especially on the bot lane because with the Kai'Sa and Rakan, it's very free kills. And Tahm, Kench was already bullying Aatrox last game, so he can just do that again with the TF.
And it kind of feels like Lissandra's a good go button for team fights. It didn't seem like Red Side had a lot of good engage without the Rakan anymore. Yeah. So it's a decent go button. Lissandra can go in, kind of, you know, try to root as many people as she can, and then ult herself, and then Terra can be running up with his ulted team. So it's a good, easy team fight for objectives for Red Side.
Yeah, they do have a very relaxed team fight though, because if they ever try to make a team fight start on the side of Rabbit Raccoons, Trundle can pillar the back line away, make it harder for them to get into the fight, and then he just has to ult their Sejuani and make her pretty useless. So it'll make it really easy for the Xayah to melt her down. Once Xayah gets 3 items, it's going to be very hard for Sejuani to stand up against that.
Yeah, that's true. And if Xayah does get caught out by a Sejuani ulti, a lot of the times they don't really get one shot in the Sejuani ulti. They do a lot of damage. They take a lot of damage in Sejuani ult, and then they die like a second after. But she'll be able to Xayah ulti and stall for long enough to get her front line ahead of her.
Plus, they do have the Taric as well, so the shield and the healed will come out on top of that. Plus, he should be rushing Knight's Vow this game.
Mm-hmm.
So, might actually keep her alive pretty easy. And in my opinion, she should rush probably third item a QSS. So, instead of going straight, so she's going to have to wait till 4 or like her 3.5 items, because her half item should be QSS, in my opinion.
Yeah, definitely, 100%.
And if she gets that QSS, it makes the team fight for Rabid Raccoons not very good. Matt, Twisted Fate planning on running the cleanse so he doesn't get bullied in lane, because if he does not, then it's just free kills for Trundle if he ever blows his flash.
Oh.
They do have a very beefy fight, though.
Kind of feel like if you're planning on picking TF, it's not like a terrible idea to kind of leave Kindred open, because it puts a lot of pressure for Kindred to go get marks, but you can always be there first.
Yeah.
You can stay mid and you can ult out. It's kind of like a riskier way of playing that situation, but you can definitely bait the enemy team into making like very pressured calls.
Yeah. I don't think if you're planning on leaving the Kindred open, though, you want to, or I don't think if you're planning on picking Sejuani, you want to leave Trundle open or Kindred. But I think having Kindred in Sejuani would be better than having Trundle, because Trundle's just going to take all your armor.
Definitely.
Yeah. I don't know. The only damage output they really have late game is going to be the Kai'Sa. Like, TF's obviously going to do damage, but it's not consistent damage, and it's not high burst either. He's just going to have some poke here and there, but it's all going to be about picks. Need to be using Tahm Kench ult and ulting Sejuani into the back line. Having Rakan engage with TF ult and Kai'Sa, and they could easily with that, like, just use all their ultimates and pick off Desire very quickly.
Hmm.
But then I don't know if they have the damage to kill the front line.
Yeah, we'll have to see here. Interestingly enough, I guess I don't know. Big question mark to me is just still the Lissandra pick, but the rest of the comp for Vortex is really good, so it may not be a big problem.
Honestly,
I was going to say
the TF pick is my big question mark, because it's not needed.
It's not, but it is kind of nice to add some additional pressure to the Kai'Sa lane. Help her get through laning phase a little bit by bait roaming with your ulti, not using it, but like being ready to.
Yeah, but he also had a lot of good pressure on Lucian, and that's not like a huge mid laner that's going to be roaming all the time, in my opinion. Like, I think he could have picked a higher damage output mage and been just fine. And really, I think he should have went an AD champion in mid lane, if possible.
Yeah.
Because right now they're all AP basically on that team, because Kai'Sa should be going AP.
He picked TF after Lissandra, right?
Actually, I don't know when he picked, but
if he did, he could have just ran Lucian into it again and just got USS pretty comfortably.
I mean, it would have been better, in my opinion, because then they would have the damage output. They wouldn't have the wave clear, but they would have the damage, and they could have been team fought. They could have team fought a lot better. The TF pick is just very questionable. I don't know. There's a lot of champions that were up that could have been picked, in my opinion. I don't know. I'm trying to think, actually, of any other names. But
sorry, we'll see if the power of friendship from Raccoons is enough to win them this game, tie up the series.
I believe in them. Like, Orianna. Orianna been, like, amazing.
Yeah, that's probably true.
She's really good right now. I mean,
is she?
I think she's very good. She just got a buff, and with just the Luden spike, she does a lot of damage.
What do you build on her now?
Luden's into... I can double check the exact build path for you. Let me see. So, people go Luden's into Morello into... Besides Power of Evil and his troll builds. And then Zhonya's or Deathcap most of the time.
Yeah, it's pretty much a staple build for a lot of mid laners right now, actually.
Yeah. But, I mean, that's a lot of damage on her, in my opinion.
Yeah. I love playing Orianna, so...
Luden's into Morello's, what was said in chat.
If your team needs an Orianna, dude, I mean.
Cough, cough. Oh, we can't do this. I'm on stream. All right. So loading in finally.
How's the early advantage here? Should we look for plays out of these two teams?
The early advantage is definitely going to be coming into the side of Rabid Raccoons, in my opinion, because they have a lot more pick coming on with the Rakan, and then Kai'Sa can follow
TF.
Rabid Raccoons drafted another early game team. Lissandra is going to do decent in the mid lane, but going to keep up the pressure against TF early. And then basically they both have equal wave clear for the majority of this game, unless one of them gets a snowball. Tahm Kench is going to bully Aatrox again, in my opinion. But Loker does have the advantage on Trundle over Sejuani.
Oh, yeah. So, at pretty much every point of the game.
Yeah, the Xayah is going to have a harder shove, and Tara can keep her alive. But if they ever get a gank or form five-man bot, they're just going to steamroll over the bot lane pretty hard, which is what bot lane Rabid Raccoons has to be doing. They have to put the Tahm Kench R on Sejuani, pick her up, throw her in the bot lane, TF ult, five-man bot, pick Xayah.
Whoa.
Oh, language.
Yeah,
there's a language barrier in here. I'm sorry.
Language barrier, yeah. 12-year-old imports in the chat.
I'm sorry, guys. Oh, look, I have a health bar on the Nexus. Or not the Nexus, the pool fountain laser.
Yeah, yeah.
Look,
it's
it has no mana.
Boom. Yeah, it's a boom.
Yeah, that sucks. Maybe it doesn't get mana until after 13 seconds.
Yeah.
Let's see the starting item. Sejuani. Going with the obvious refill potions, but Trundle showing how big of a man he is, grabbing that Reju bead, saying, I'm picking up that early Tiamat, and you're not going to stop me.
Lissandra here, already almost full build. With the Doran's Ring, Health Pot, freaking Stopwatch, Dematerial. Oh my goodness.
The activatables, he knows how to push his number keys.
Right? Played AD last game. Now he's playing support with all the actives.
Hey, don't worry about him though. He knows how to do it. He's well practiced on the ability of hitting his number keys. He does play Talon and Zed. Multiple number keys activated on that one.
Yeah, yeah. A whole bunch of R and then auto.
Hey, you got the Tiamat proc. You got the Bork if you still do that on Zed. I don't. Ghost Blade on one
probably
of them.
Probably go Morello's on Zed too, dude. That item's busted.
Yeah, you can go Morello on him, and then they're not going to have any grievous wounds.
Yeah, against Rocket or something.
Yeah. Obviously, the Executioner's Calling is just not worth it.
Yeah, not gold efficient. You get HP from Morello's, and it's just really
Twisted
great.
Fate trying to get the ward out over here against Lissandra, but she's showing him how much pressure she puts with that champion.
You have directed camera off, dude? Are you cheating?
What? I can look at my mini-map. It's a perks of being a jungler.
Yeah, I don't do that. I play mid.
That's why you get camps.
I'm CSing. I'm walking in the Lucian level 2 and dying.
Giving him a very nice leash on the Trundle.
Yeah, very good.
Sejuani.
If I was there, I would have taken it. Big mistake.
All right, Tahm Kench. Getting the CS lead top already. Never mind. Aatrox pulling it in.
Yeah, look at that. Oh, my goodness.
4-2.
Double the farm of Tahm Kench. Oh.
Ooh, they're each jungler is swapping around, though.
Yep.
I like it a lot. Knowing their strengths and weaknesses.
Oh. Ooh. Ooh, Terror taking a lot of damage here.
Alf says this is his lane. He's not losing again.
Yeah, Alf's like, Kram's not down here. I have pressure. Sejuani ganking top. Let's see, flash on Aatrox. Aatrox joining the enemy team. Not sure why he would walk.
Wait, why am I directive camera?
Ooh. Okay, first blood on top. That's unfortunate. Didn't blow any summoners at least, but a little lazy on his part. Should have definitely been expecting the gank.
Yeah, his jungler was bot side, so if your jungler is going to be taking that scuttle bot side, you have to be playing safe top lane.
Mm-hmm.
Especially if you don't see the Sejuani going to match that scuttle, you know she's going to be top.
100% the fact that like most junglers start where their bot side is as well, so he should know that she was going to be going top.
Ooh.
PF. Good trades on both sides mid. I feel like Lissandra comes out ahead of that one with the fact that she has TP. Ooh, Tarik getting his bone plating popped.
Beastnake showing how good his Tahm Kench is.
Yeah. Hoping to eliminate another team from the peak up with that champ, apparently.
Yikes.
My team wasn't enough. Scored them.
Obviously.
I still heard about one of it. Like, I physically feel pain about one of his Tahm Kench ults on my team. I just, like, aced us. I remember it. It was bad.
Jeez. So.
Ooh, going the Bambi Cinder early. Wants that pressure. He wants that push in that top lane.
Bot lane needs to be careful. They should know Sejuani's on the bot side of the map. She cleared the top early. But
it's true. They don't know if she could be setting up for a gank somewhere. that's a pretty weak ward out of Kurama mid. I do not like that ward. You don't see enough.
He obviously has no fear.
Yeah. His top lane already gave up first blood, so he has nothing to worry about. He can die and be fine. It's not first blood.
Exactly. It doesn't matter head sex. That's what he thinks.
Agreed. I mean, can't argue with that. It's just great shot calling coming out of Overrate.
Everyone keeping up pretty even in CS right now, even though there's a nice gold lead going over the side of Rabid Raccoons right now.
There is, yeah. Almost, I think it's what, like...
It's about 600
right now?
Yeah.
Yeah. Quick mass.
Quick mass.
So, does Aatrox's jumpy jump ability where he smacks down and knocks him up, is that your percentage? Oh, we'll talk about this bottom lane fight. Rakan getting caught out. Oh, flashes forward. I think the Ignite had it. But they're pushing up for Xayah. Xayah's able to get away, does a little bit of extra damage to the Q, but not enough to do anything significant. Rakan does go down, showing the opposite of how you should play Rakan from last game. But anyway, back to an important topic. Does Aatrox dance jump ability, does that do percentage health, or how does that work?
Ooh, what
does
that ability let's do? Read that ability real quick, because I don't know.
Oh, you can. That's right. I could just click that. Whoops.
Let's see. His Q. Aatrox slams his great sword down, dealing 50 plus 64 physical damage. Wow. The dark. Wow. Oh, it switched over.
Direct the camera. OP.
Dark Blade may be recast 2 additional times, each one increasing in damage, and it did it again.
Oh, bot lane gank coming out. Xayah flashes, kind of a weak flash, but gets away, doesn't get stunned. Trundle's down here, drops the pillar.
Oh, overextending.
Yeah, kind of getting too far up. They get the Ignite out.
Stun from Manwaters.
Oh, good flash from Sedge. It most surely been her death. Scripting or something. Yeah, I don't know what Trundle was doing there.
It was an overextension from both teams, in my opinion.
Maybe he just wanted
TF ult coming down.
Ultia gets the stun.
Oh my Rakan goodness.
Knocks up. Alf gets the kill. Very important that Alf gets the kill there.
Never going to be able to read this.
Well, it said flat damage, so I doubt it does percentage, too.
You're supposed to actually hold, like, something over his abilities to see the damage. I don't know. I don't think it has percent health. But you know what? I know how to solve this.
I know his passive does.
Aatrox Wiki.
Oh, no.
Gonna come out with this.
Quality casting here. We're giving you the news.
Just gotta make sure. 65% to 100% based on level damage to minions. So it's the 65% early game to damage to minions, and then bases up to 100 throughout the game. And
is that like one of the only abilities that actually changes its effectiveness against minions?
Don't know. I don't want to lie and say yes or no. Burst swing does 64% AD up to 80% based on how many points you have in it. Second swing does 96% to 120% AD based off the 1 through 5 points. And the third one does 240% to 300% AD based off points.
I feel so bad for like the people in Twitch chat that already know Aatrox's ability. It's like they're just like listening to us talk about all this data for no reason. Something I wanted to point out here, Aizen with a good CS lead, able to bring back some of this gold deficit.
It's now
down to...
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. It's now down to 300. Although Kai'Sa is about to get a fat wave right here. Oh. Stun on the Trundle. Half his health gone. Let's see how this turns out here. How much of this Kai'Sa gets?
She did get a nice back, almost getting two components of her Rage Blade.
It's true. Oh, okay.
Ooh,
the scuttle.
Should be a free pick coming in from.
Oh no,
Sejuani. Never mind.
Oh,
turned it around.
Tom Kench coming in. Oh, he doesn't get the yellow card.
Blue carded.
Ooh, good knock up there by Aatrox. Good flash coming out of TF. Really scrappy right now.
Huge misplay on the side of Rabid Raccoons.
Really good reaction coming out of Kurama there to roam up in time.
Did. Very good reactions coming out of the Vortex. They had nice roams on that side. They easily could have had that pick with the Sejuani.
Oh, could be.
Flash
coming out.
Trundle still going for that Scuttle Crab.
Really well played by Vortex there, too. Taric had it, so she couldn't run down. But if she also ran up, she gets stunned by Xayah. flash in by Tom. Ooh. Looking to eat. Oh, the Sedro coming in. They make it. TF. Oh, Krama has to flash.
They're not on the same page at all right now. Vortex needing their substitute mid laner to come in and save the day again.
Oh, no. Yeah, castle I play. Alrighty. Aatrox getting cut out. Not sure what he's doing in there. Maybe looking for a kill. You know, 2-0. He's getting real hungry for something.
We did know on last game, Vortex has a shaky early game, pulls it back together once the mid game comes along.
What are you trying to say, brother? We had a losing mid. How's Ryze?
Hey, it's fine.
What do you mean, dude?
Shaky early game, but they're going to pull it back again, hopefully.
What do you mean? Anyway, my feelings aren't hurt. Kai'Sa doing something bot lane.
Throwing the W out. Hitting Man Walrus. Yeah, almost getting stunned up.
Hoping not to get the L. Hey. I'm retiring after this game. I've peaked.
Oh, God, I'm dying.
Still a decent, like a respectable CS lead coming out for Zaya here. Is definitely nothing.
All eight CS at 10 minutes. Doing wonderful.
Hey, that's a whole wave. That's more than a whole wave.
Six. So he got about a wave advantage. Maybe a little
that's
more.
That's good. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he's doing wonderful.
But I guess maybe Azai against Kai'Sa, you want a little bit more early.
All right, so coming up with the Sejuani ultimate, they need to be looking for a nice five-man ultimate bot lane.
Mm-hmm.
Tahm Kench walking down, taking this big L to Vortex.
Oh, there's some action going on the river. Never mind, that's Rakan's on their team. I'm actually...
super action, clearing a pink ward.
Yeah, clearing the pink ward. Oh my, Rakan steals it.
Oh. Beastnake showing no fear in it. Oh.
Yeah, he doesn't care. TF's coming with the ulti.
Wait.
Aatrox does not have flash, but he has the blood. His ulti thing. We're both trying to play-by-play at the same time. I like it.
No, sorry. My directive camera went crazy.
It's okay. Okay, they're getting the yellow card ready. All right, good kill. Kurama not really wanting to roam up. Interested about that play. He was just like, you know, I'll come for the rest. I'll come for my jungler, but not for my top laner. You can stay 0-3.
Mass disrespect from last game. He said, you ended last game. You can end again.
Yeah, in the pregame, he was like, can I play Riven for like 10 minutes? And we were all telling him no. So maybe a little bit of anger. Trundle getting caught out here, running towards TF. But the bot lane's coming up. Zandra's here, has the ulti. It's going to ult on the... Okay, no, they focus on to Khan instead. Taric ults for the river damage or something. Oh. Tahm Kench getting licked. Or licking Aatrox, rather. They get the air dragon. Definitely a respectable dragon to have.
Tahm Kench didn't lose to Aatrox. Tahm Kench beat Aatrox both games so far. Aatrox has been kind of getting manhandled top lane both games by a Tahm Kench, showing him how big his tongue really is.
Exactly. Ooh. All right, gank going on bot lane. The slow with a stun onto Kai'Sa. Kai'Sa has her ulti. See how she wants to play this. Running away, maybe to ult. Ooh. Mamor's getting the kill.
Uckler says he's not having any of this.
Yeah. They did get the ignite from Man Walrus, so hopefully they ping that somewhere.
It's all right.
Looking for the first turret, maybe?
Vortex not doing their job with this game and using the Tahm Kench ultimate to bring the Sejuani with the TF ultimate, making it a 5-man, 5v2 bot lane. Still have yet to do
insane.
That. They're actually giving up the first blood tower.
With all that global pressure, yeah, giving up that first turret, definitely not what you want to do.
Super
Vortex with almost 600 gold lead now.
Yeah. Swinging that gold is huge. They need to get their coordination together. Look at this, they have Sejuani ultimate coming up, TF ultimate coming up, Kai'Sa ultimate, whatever about that one. But we can keep going, and they can easily
Rakan
play. Tahm Kench ult's coming up, or Tahm Kench is shoving this lane. All they need to do is, he needs to back up, pick up his Sejuani, and the Kai'Sa's in the wrong spot. They can't do this play anymore.
Yeah, the lane swap coming out.
It is best.
Delayed reaction. Delayed reaction coming out of Kai'Sa, or Raccoons in general, to not respect the swap and understand. We were calling now. Oh, never mind. Not sure what Kai'Sa's doing, just chilling. Tahm Kench looks to be walking down there. Kai'Sa has TP, so maybe that's what she's waiting for. He's just gonna TP up there or just run up there herself.
Oh my goodness, why won't it let me drag this thing? It won't let me drag it.
Blade track what?
This is one over to Vortex.
Oh, are you doing the overlay?
Yeah.
Oh no. Yeah, Javante got outplayed by that too. Oh, looking for a Herald play. Not sure if blue team sees this at all.
Yeah, it won't work.
Okay, blue team pings for it. They know what's going on. Herald still is pretty high health. Tahm Kench does not have ult or TP, but he has ulti. Hopefully he can get in range. They see the health of Herald with the stun. Okay. Oh, really good play by Uckler, but Taric with a responsive ulti. Team fight coming in. Oh, Kai'Sa needs to live. Kai'Sa lives. Oh, but Aatrox is behind them. Not able to do anything. They're completely sandwiched. Oh, they flash onto the Lissandra. Can they get the kill? The Hourglass stopwatch coming in. Does she get away? She flashes. Aizen gets the kill. Aatrox chasing onto the TF. Tahm Kench trying to crawl away. He's trying to swim. Oh, he changes direction.
Wait, TF's going in for the pick on the...
Oh, take the plant, take the plant. Oh, he doesn't get pulled back in.
Oh, my God.
Aatrox is insane.
Oh, my God. I can't. Oof. All I'm saying is Rabbit Raccoons have to get a shot call in their team fights. They're so uncoordinated.
Yeah, they're so split. They're all going for different dumpsters, you know.
Oh, I would not say Vortex is a dumpster this game, but if that's what you would like to call them, you'd be my guest.
Raccoons lore in real life, they scavenge through dumpsters, you know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, but we're saying Rabbit Raccoons is the ones that's uncoordinated, and then you're saying they're diving into the dumpsters of Vortex. I say Vortex isn't a dumpster.
They're going into different dumpsters. They're choosing different dumpsters.
It's fine.
You know
Vortex, you're doing amazing. I believe in you.
Yeah.
You're not a dumpster. It's okay.
No, I'm calling them a dumpster so people continue to sleep on them and disrespect them, and they continue to pull out these wins against GBC. You know, Vortex showed him who daddy is.
Ganked by Christ?
It's close. I think it's a...
Ooh, Sejuani ult coming in.
Oh. Good CC chain there.
Nice pick.
Not able to do anything. Has her ulti. TP coming in from... Is that Zaya? That's Zaya, but they may be able to... No, they can't take the turret. Oh, Sejuani just barely getting away. Oh, Taric stun. Oh, Kai'Sa doing tons of damage. It's the extra auto.
She doesn't even have the Triforce, and she's doing tons of damage.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Vortex. Three dead for nothing. And Raccoons still have a lot of HP. They're very fortunate that it's not closer to Baron right now, because they could have, you know, done a Baron bait play.
Why is my directed camera not going off?
Are they going to get two turrets here? Raccoons going into the dumpster.
Yikes.
Oh, TF a little bit far up, but it doesn't matter.
We're talking about misplays, miscommunication coming out of the side of Rabbit Raccoons, and they do the caster curse and actually do a good job, work together as a team, make the picks, get the tower, get the damage on the tier 2, and manages to steal the blue buff away from Vortex's side.
Wowzers. They're ghosting.
I believe in them. I believe in both teams.
Yeah, so we're trying I can to get pull this the to Kobe. Go to a game 3.
Exactly. I can pull a Kobe and I can just say, I never doubted them.
I never doubted them. That was hype, dude. I love that MSI.
That was very nice of MSI. So, looking at the build.
Uh oh. Looking at TF getting caught with the cleanse. What are you doing? Could have just dodged the thing.
Could have just dodged it, but chose not to.
Decided to be like, I can stun too.
Now they're going to lose. Oh, Tahm Kench using the ultimate finally. Top.
They really want to kill... Oh, Aatrox got... Okay, the trade ult for ult there. Nothing too big of a deal. I guess Aatrox ult's pretty big as well because it does give him an extra revive. Tahm Kench ult probably equally as important for plays. But now they have two top for this dragon. Can't say well played out of them.
Another misplay, but it's fine.
And go for the steal.
No, definitely not worth the gold. They do have Zaya almost getting up on the two items part. Oh, looking for another pick though.
Gone getting over the wall.
What is the button for gold, do you know?
The what?
To show gold? What's the button?
It's like X, right?
Is it X? No, it's not X. Oh, maybe hang on. It is X. You lied. I lied. You lied and
I lied.
Can't be my fault. Yeah. Come on, don't you know who I am?
Yeah, you're overrated or something.
Exactly. Right? So, a 500 gold lead on the side of Kai'Sa. Hence why she's almost got her second item completed, and Zaya does not. huge, commanding 1,600 goal lead, 1,500 goal lead coming out from TF on Lissandra. That's insane.
Wow. Oh, yeah, I didn't even notice that he's 4-0-4.
800 goal lead for Sejuani. A nice 800 goal lead for Tom Kinch.
Yeah. Not going to lie, though, not really good allocation of gold by Raccoons. He definitely went that gold under. Uh-oh. No cleanse. Maybe setup, though. Sick ulti. Okay, Terra Gold's coming in. They're trying to retreat here. Zaya's here.
Oh, no.
Ooh, good hex tag.
What? Why?
Oh,
what?
Oh, why not, brother? Going in just in time for Baron, perhaps?
Oh, Shubba my mid. God. Talking up the Rabid Raccoons just for them to get annihilated in a team fight.
Big mistake.
Should not have Caster Curse. Caster Curse.
That's Overrated's fault right there. See if they go for a potential Baron play. It looks like TF still hasn't healed yet. All right, he's healing now, but he does have ulti. But they're just opting for the safer play. Just get the T2, you know, reset.
Huge misposition. Gold. Huge misposition on the side of Rabid Raccoons.
Yeah. Maybe if TF had cleanse, he could play that far up, but he knew he didn't have cleanse. There's no real reason to be up that far. My opinion.
Huge problem is Rakan's going in, and no one can go with him. He's just getting demolished in that time.
But also, Tarek is doing a really good job at alleviating a lot of
bad. You stop these bad puns right now. I got messaged.
Oh,
Zaya picking off the Kai'Sa. Flash coming out.
Ooh. If only Kai'Sa had ultimate and didn't use it. Oh, Aizen with the BM. If you saw this.
If only the Kai'Sa didn't get hit by those auto attacks. Would have been
remember, she wasted the ulti to go into Vortex's team.
She did. When she also went tried to 1v1 a Zaya. And she doesn't have two items.
She had the gold lead, though, right?
It doesn't matter. You have the item differences, though. She's going into a Storm Razor, automatic crit.
But overrate. You lose all the fights you don't take. You know what I'm saying?
You lose 100% of the fights you don't take, and you'll lose 80% of them when you go into a bush and Isaiah's sitting there.
Hey, there's that 20%. Ooh. Looking for the mid. Good charm. The catch on Lissandra. Lissandra might ult herself. Yep, does, but she's Grievous Wounds. Ooh. It's not going to be that big of a deal. Hourglass. This is a really long. They needed the TP way sooner. Oh, miscommunication.
Rakan having to flash.
Oh, okay. Sejuani ult to disengage. They get a free pick. Tom Kinch is running away. Very spooked. Oh, the flash onto Tom Kinch. Kai'Sa's topside, too, so there's not really much they can do here. Had flash.
Coordination effect right here. Kai'Sa's going top lane, and they're engaging on the Lissandra.
Right.
What? She does have TP.
I think that was actually... I think that was more just on Tom Kinch. Honestly, you could have flashed the Tom or the Taric stun. If Taric's going to be using it like that on you, you know he's going to be trying to flash. So just disrespect coming out of Tom Kinch. You know?
Disrespect to the team. That's what I feel like. I feel like this is a team.
Disrespect to the team.
Ooh,
we got Bobby.
TF coming in.
Oh.
Trying to pick the support.
Taric solo ulti. That's a good cooldown to have off. They can look for a fight, a big fight. Ooh. Kai'Sa gets the kill. Full health for Kai'Sa. Has the QSS. Dead or something. Alright.
It's alright. Yeah. They left Kai'Sa to die instead of the Sejuani. Now they're just getting a free Baron.
Yep.
Rabid Raccoon showing us hope, pulling an NA classic, giving us hope dangling in front of our face, and then getting it yanked out from underneath us.
Raccoons is definitely the KT of Prophecy Cup. Looking good and then looking not good.
Looks good for a game.
Yep.
Huge upset comes out, and they just lose their next game.
They're the Burger King advertisements, you know, the billboards. It looks so delicious, and you get your burger, and it looks like someone stepped on it. That's what Raccoons are able to do in one game.
We don't judge the stepped-on burgers. They have feelings, too, you know.
They do, and they also still taste great, so that's what it's all about. Yeah. You know, like, goodness is on the inside.
Exactly. That's why I believe every team has a chance to make a miracle happen. So far, Rabid Raccoons are... slowly making that chance go away, but it's fine. They do have glimmering moments.
They need that Christ team. What was that team?
Exactly.
Ganked
by Christ. Is that
ganked by Christ. They need him to come in, give him some help, give him a miracle or two.
That's what GBC stands for. Everyone knows.
Ganked by Christ.
All right, we got it. This should be an easy pick. They know that they just backed. They had vision on two people recalling, I believe. They should be setting this up, and said Kai'Sa's going for the farm yet again in a bad position for her team. Alf.
Maybe just tilted. You know, the nerves definitely set in when you're down in a series, and then you're down in the game that decides the series. So maybe it's just nerves.
But it's only two towers to three towers, and it's such a close gold lead.
Yep.
This team fight could decide the game over this dragon. What dragon is it? It's a Cloud Drake.
Oh. Clouds. Oh, Kurama actually taking that in.
Very nice, O'Connell.
Oh, good team fight. Terracle coming in really delayed. They eat the Zaya, and she can't be saved by the Tom Kinchult. Zaya gets over the wall, though. Well played by Aizen.
Oh, TF.
TF looking for the ulti. Will he get the... Oh, who's that guy? Trundle? Yeah, Trundle flashes.
Tarek? No, it's Tarek.
Yeah, oh. Tarek. Talia, who knows? Oh, Kai'Sa taking the ultimate in. Oh, good stun.
Kai'Sa,
somehow,
what are you doing? Kai'Sa.
Kai'Sa melee moding it. TF stalls for TF to get out. You know, we're...
In the wise words of Toxic Ramen Lover, she said, "Jesus, take the wheel. I'm going in."
I mean, yeah. I can believe that one right there.
She thought she had Infinity Edge, like you said earlier, and wanted to do the tons of damage.
Yes. She's like, "Oh no, I bought this useless Rageblade item instead. My bad, team."
She said, "TF, why you have Lich Bane?" Alright, so... If Rabid Raccoons want to win this game, they've got to stop trying to 5v5. They don't win it. They need to pick. They need to be using the Tom Kinch Lejuani together with the recline engage and getting into the backline.
Once you're done with your point, on the bright side, they did waste a lot of the Baron.
On the bright side, the Nexus is still up.
Yeah, on the bright side.
In the wide words of Skara, it's not over till the Nexus is gone. Or whatever he said. Paraphrase right. There.
He said, until they lost, they were winning.
Yeah, that's what he said. The wise words of Scar.
They were winning until they lost.
You're winning until you lose.
Yo, that's it. That's the mentality you need in this game.
In the wise words of I'm a Cutie Pie, if you don't know what you're doing, how the fuck are they supposed to know what you're doing?
Look who's bot.
Look
who's
at Kai'Sa. TPing in, using her TP.
Yup. I feel like at that point you can just recall. Oh no.
Sejuani. Ooh, 5-man knockup from the recall.
Oh my goodness, Ugly. You're
doesn't
nasty.
Even matter.
Okay, but this is fine. Kai'Sa really can't do anything right now, anyways. Kind of a waste of Terracle. Oh, get the Aatrox.
Oh, Recon, what are you doing?
They can still look for this, honestly. Big cooldowns are down. Lissandra doesn't have ulti. Oh, they're looking. They need to do
they
something.
They can still win this fight.
Oh, the yellow one? Okay. Oh, they get the stun. Kai'Sa needs to get in there. Kai'Sa is in there like swimwear. Kai'Sa has ulti. Who's she gonna ult on? Take the wheel. GBC. Going in. Terek flash. She flashes
Alf,
in.
Alf, what are you doing? Alf! That was Kai'Sa's team fight to win.
Oh, even had flash. It's like, why melee? The cleanse. Oh, he gets the Q. Uckler, you're nasty. Okay.
Oh, jeez.
DF. Sejuani gets there.
Sejuani, why are you running?
Yeah, why are you running? It's the W.
Oh my goodness, the coordination is just not there.
Lissandra has TP. Let's see what they choose to do here. They look for, under turret. But he's really a tanky boy. We would get out of there. Yeah, I don't know, Raccoons. I have faith in you guys before the series started. I knew you guys were a good team, but whatever you guys have been practicing, if this is the, you know, the fruits of your labor, dig up that tree and get a new tree, because that is not working.
What is DTS talking about in chat? Jesus, that is Jajaint? I don't know what that means. Gigaint?
You don't question DTS. He's in a league of his own, you know what I'm saying?
In the wise words of General Odd One, you don't outplay the enemies, you wait for them to outplay themselves. The motto of Vortex.
Yeah, right? That's actually really true.
Gigaint.
The Giga Int.
Yes, that was. They had that team fight won. Alf.
Alf just.
Being Alf at this point. He's pulling a wild turtle and going in too far. He has the play. He can sense it. Tip it on the.
He didn't pull
very
the trigger. He threw the whole gun.
he ran out of bullets and threw the gun at him. Yeah.
He had a full clip. He had a full clip. He just threw it at him and then they took it and killed him with it. That's exactly what happened.
He was trying to mug a Vortex, and Vortex got the gun stripped right out from under him.
Oh man, Alf.
Every ult looks sweet as Kai'Sa until you die instantly. He didn't even die instantly. He went in.
He melee moded.
And then he just kept going forward and didn't auto.
The thing is like, if the back line is low enough where they can't safely walk up, just kill the front line. Yeah. Just attack Trundle. You effectively did your job of killing the back line if they can't assist.
On the bright side, they only lost one inhibitor.
That's true. But they lost it to a team that didn't really even have Baron anymore.
But on the bright side, it was only one.
Yeah, that's right. But on the bright side, they're winning until they're lost.
Yeah. It's not over until the Nexus is over.
Yeah. They may be almost down 10k, you know, but... You know, if you're never down, how are you going to know when you're up? You know,
hey, but that's this is what happens, is you get down 10k, and then the TK comes out to play.
Oh, yeah. Oh, bars. Okay.
All right, let's do that. So if you want to look for a pick...
Yo, big tanky boys.
Lissandra's bot lane. Tahm Kench can ult in the back line.
STP. She's looking for the ulti on...
Ooh. Tahm Kench ults in the back.
Terracol is down. Lissandra gets a good TP. Really good TP. Gonna get the TF there. Just really smart fight by Vortex. I'm sure they were communicating about that ward teleport. Just really good. They can just go top it in the game.
But what they weren't communicating about on the side of Rabbit Raccoons is how to play the team fights.
Yeah.
All I heard out of their comms were, I'm dead.
I'm dead. I'm giving the wheel.
My hands off the keyboard and I said, Jesus, take it, please.
Right?
What he said is, you're dead.
Yup. Rest in peace.
That's all right.
They get the mid in him.
Vortex.
They get the safe play again. Maybe you should just go for Baron, because they're not going to end at this point.
They're going to end. They have 14 seconds. There's no way they're not ending.
Yeah, never mind. Yeah. Strike that.
Who's going to stop them? The Rakan? The only player on the team going in? And Sejuani finally does what he's supposed to and goes in.
GG Vortex.
All right, so... I'm going to have to give my most valuable player of the series to Man Walrus. I think he played phenomenally. He's the only one that didn't have super mistakes the
whole
time.
Really well. I think we probably should, just for the fact that Man Walrus has been interviewed enough, I think we should...
I'm just saying that's my MVP. I'm not saying that's who MVP. We should interview.
Okay, no, MVP definitely. I'll give you that one.
All right.
A good call. I vote Loker.
I would like to interview Loker just because I want to hear his side of how far he was behind on the Kindred and still managed to come back from that. I don't know if I can pull people in. We're going to try. I can't. Let me find someone who can.
Worst case scenario, maybe we could just all, you, him, and I go to the meeting room, perhaps? But
I'm gonna
someone
find
from the
someone.
Stream I join and say some stuff, so maybe
yeah,
not.
Let's not do
we'll
that.
We'll just find somebody else.
Hang
Plain
on.
Plain and safe. Oh, he is deafened currently. Hello, brother.
Hello?
Oh.
May
need to leave and come back. Your mic's really bad.
Your mic is horrible. Fix
that
for the interview.
That's not how his mic sounds. Well, he can't come back.
How did he get in here?
Oh, wait, how did he get in? Someone drag him in? Hello? Dad? Oh, hello?
What's up?
There we go. What's up, Luger?
Nothing much.
All right, so... I'll have to ask you a quick question. What are your thoughts on the game 1 and 2? How did y'all get the success?
I mean, Rabid Raccoons is, like, not a good team. So going into it, we kind of thought we had an advantage. And then I inted. But other than that, both games are pretty... I mean, the game 2, I played pretty well. Game 1, I inted pretty hard early.
Both true facts.
Really know the matchup in Tatalia. So, I'm sure that's going to be your next question is, like, why did I int 3 times in a row on Kindred?
I wasn't actually going to ask you that. I was just going to ask you how you got through the obvious tilt that was coming out and managed to come back and play really well for the second half of that game.
I have a big question after that, too.
I wasn't really tilted because every single time I died, I got a stack. And when you get a stack on Kindred, it, like, feels good, man. So, I got that stack on Raptors, and then there was another play where I died, and I got the stack on... Talia, because my excellent mid laner, who's definitely not a caster, killed him after I died. So when I got 4 stacks at 11 minutes, I was like, it's all right, baby. We'll just farm up, dude, and we'll play it the old-fashioned way.
Yeah, I mean, right. to be honest, you died for a permanent attack range boost, right? Because you get boosts of your attack range.
Hell yeah, brother.
So they can't buy attack range boost. You get it. I'm dying.
Yeah, they can have all the kills they want. They want, but if I die, I get attack range.
Yep. Alrighty.
Sounds like a good idea.
So, how did you feel how did you feel playing Trundle, picking Trundle, and then them taking Sejuani? I literally
screamed in champ select.
You screamed in champ select.
I said that was a bad idea.
I was like, yeehaw! Dude, I was ready, dude. I was like, because there was really nothing left that was, like, good in the jungle. That's why I picked Trundle. We didn't pick our mid, we picked Trundle, because the only two champs that Trundle really hard loses to, I mean, I guess Taliyah is also pretty hard, but
you banned her.
Graves and Kindred both. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Kindred, Graves, and Taliyah were all banned. So, once those three champs are banned, there's, like, nothing that stands up to Trundle in the jungle. And I guess he could have picked Zin, but
he could have picked
Nidalee,
but then with the Tahmkench. I'm not saying he is, but Nidalee is good into Trundle. But the problem is they had the Tahmkench top, and they didn't use it effectively.
Yeah, I don't. Are people banning this? Because we were talking about how his Tahmkench is good, and that he hasn't actually played it in any game so far.
I don't know.
We didn't ban it because we were like, he's probably not going to play. And then he played it two games in a row, and it like did okay, but it didn't like have like an effect. Like it like neutralized the Aatrox lane, but like why did they just not ban Aatrox and then like pick something else top?
See,
because like Tahmkench doesn't offer anything if you're not using his ult to like
that was the problem. They had easy success in this game. All they had to do was take the Tahmkench, pick up the Sejuani, put her behind
the bot lane, or the mid lane.
Put them behind the bot lane, and then have TF ult, and you have 5-man bot, free tower, and dragon. Anytime.
Especially because our Lissandra didn't take cleanse, which is another thing that I was a little nervous about. Lissandra didn't take cleanse, so if they came with Sejuani, and they could keep like in some of those mid game fights, the ones we were kind of throwing a little bit was because Lissandra couldn't get her ult and Zhonya's off before all the CC came out, and they would just burst her, and then we had one less person, which is like what their comp wants to do.
Did a really good job at nullifying the Rakan engages. That was like really absurd how useless Rakan was.
Manwalrus, MVP of that series.
Yeah, Manwalrus is a beast. And the problem is, like, first game, I understand, like, because I was worried that was going to happen to us where they banned out the three supports and that Walrus performs well on. But he popped off on Rakan. So I feel like game two, you don't ban any supports because, like, he's so proficient on Braum, Alistar, and Tark, and he proved that he can play Rakan too, so like, well, that doesn't really work.
It's weird because I think the way they handled the draft is actually really well. They banned out him, and then they took the Rakan first pick because of blue side, but they banned Kindred, a champ that he didn't just int on, instead of just banning Taric. If they would have banned Taric and taken Rakan,
I had some items on Kindred, it was kind of hard for them to do anything, so I understand why Kindred was frustrating, especially with some of the ults I had, but I did like in on it, and like from that game, even though I can assure you guys I can play it to probably like a gold 5 standard, but I played it like a bronze that game. But even if they think that I'm like good at the champ, like after I just greeted for like 6 stacks, you think you would just leave it up? And then that's what we were worried about, because we didn't want, because he also can play Morg. We were like, if we ban Morg and they ban 3 supports, then we're kind of fucked.
Yeah, well, their biggest part is they weren't picking anything for team fights. They were trying to teamfight y'all, and then they weren't picking anything for teamfights, and y'all were picking teamfight comps. So they weren't doing anything, but I have a quick question. What was the mental going on for Rexalis, and why did he keep ending?
There was literally... Are you talking about the second game? I mean, the first game, I don't really remember, but the second game, he literally, after that first gank, when Sejuani showed up level 2, he was
was great.
He's like, I didn't respect it, and then he died.
It's so true, because he, like, started walking towards their turret. It's like,
because we were talking about maybe Lissandra TPing up there, but if it wasn't, like, instant, and he didn't have enough time, he would have just died.
Yeah. No, the biggest thing is...
And then
y'all
later
knew...
he was like...
Oh, keep going?
Go ahead.
Oh, no,
you can go.
I was going to say, y'all knew you were bot lane on Trundle, and then Sejuani obviously wasn't coming to match you, so where is she going to be? Topside Scuttle.
Yeah, that's what we didn't talk about that, and then I think that's the same play we're talking about. He died top for his third death, and he was like, guys, I'm inting. Like, literally just said he was inting.
I didn't have to tell you guys, you knew.
Oh, y'all already knew that time.
and our like... Caleb is our mid laner, and he's like our rock in our team, and he was like, it's all right, guys, we're fine, it's all right. Yeah, yeah. Who cares if you're inting?
Because who cares if you're inching?
He's like, give me Riven. I want to play Riven.
No.
Give me Riven. Riven's a good matchup.
And
I went back to casting.
Like, guess what you're going to get to do?
Yeah.
Play Aatrox.
First pick the Aatrox. So that way. That's another thing I don't understand is why didn't they ban Aatrox? Like,
I don't think it was worth the ban.
Offers so much.
I just don't think it was worth the ban.
You don't think so?
No, because honestly, the Tahm Kench was a good pick into it. Their biggest problem is coordination as a team.
The non-utilization of the Tahm Kench.
Their coordination in team fights was horrible. Their coordination macro-wise was horrible. They didn't do anything. They have no shot caller, it seems like. And in team fights, they all go quiet. The only thing I probably hear in there, if I could do a mic check of their team comms, it would just be, I'm dead.
It's also really
that's something we had to work on a lot too.
It's really strange that he didn't want to opt into the Lucian again because he saw Lissandra. He could have picked Lucian again and just built QSS very comfortably, but instead he went for the TF when it wasn't really.
I think
needed.
That every single part, even if I did before this series, I really respected their bot lane. Now, I mean, my opinion has changed almost like completely.
Oh, most definitely.
Not to talk trash, but when our AD falls asleep, so we have to sub in mid laner to play bot lane, and they still get smashed like two solo kills, and he was playing Rakan like that's bad. But my point is like, Rabid Raccoons was a team that I thought was kind of good, and then like every show that they have, like the weekly review show, they always rate them like decently, and then we finally got to play them and they're just like not good at all. They don't team fight well, they don't draft well, they don't macro well, they have like nothing.
They have families.
The shots have been fired.
They have families, David.
It's okay. Like we said in one of the games, if you rewatch the series, by the way, because casting was phenomenal. But like we said, one of our analogies was Alf was trying to rob y'all in one of those team fights near the inhibitor towards the end of the game, and he gave you the gun just to kill himself because he had the fight won.
Literally, there was three Kai'Sa ults when he ulted. Our whole team was just like, what the fuck?
Yeah, we were
like, actually, simultaneously, that was our comms. We didn't need a communication.
He had the team fight won for them, and he just decided to go full melee.
By the top lane inhib where he went into me, and I just smited Titanic Hydra, Q'd him, and he just died.
Yeah, it was super well played on his part. But I'm going to have to give it a good game to you and your team.
Yeah.
Very well played your early game. I would say y'all need to get into practice and try to work on that a little bit because it's exploitable. But other than that, y'all had a really good mid to late game both games. Once you got your lead, you knew how to snowball it.
Yep. I just want everyone to know that Aizen should not get any MVP points because he fell asleep.
Ooh, he's not getting MVP points in my opinion. I'm giving him my points to Manwalrus. Both
maybe next series, but this time he's in the doghouse. Not sure for him.
Definitely in the doghouse.
True Light asked last time you guys played, because I was subbed in for a game. He said, so Kurama or Pickaxe? This time I'm going to ask, Kurama or Aizen? Who gets to keep the spot?
You're a golden glue, Seth.
Ooh.
Yes, Scrim legend.
He is the golden glue.
<Only Scrim.
laughs> Gets kicked off of every team he's on.
It was a pleasure to come interview with you guys.
Pleasure having you. Have a wonderful night, guys. See you next time.
Good night, everybody.